here's a guy that stayed true to his art. He's had carved a lot of things out in his life, had to be through a lot of things. One of the greatest writers and very successful at a very early age. And he's been a great example to me of someone who stays with an idea, doesn't give up. If it takes years, centuries, in his case maybe millenniums, he will not give up. And he follows his dream. He goes through the heartaches and the other things that other people do, but he stays with the music. And that's an inspiration for someone like me. He's the pure being. He's an authentic voice, and he's not a phony. Even though he calls me on stuff sometime, and it bothers me, but it's my reaction and not what he's saying is usually right.
With Phil Sloan, kind of a unique partnership there, you know? I think Phil, you know, is a good writing partner with Stephen, because Phil is also very spiritual. And Phil and Stephen really hit that place. They really hit that place and are very sensitive to each other and, you know, their beliefs and their spirituality. And I think that's really unique in itself.
We met at Daniel Rutherford's and Marilyn Wilson house, and the first night we met, and that night I went home and wrote a lyric, The Soul of a Woman, and within a few days he'd had a melody for it, and that was the beginning of our songwriting relationship.
The first song that we wrote together, I was in India. I had heard three chords coming out of a booth from a record store. And I had the strangest feeling, the strangest thought was that if I could capture those three chords, my life would be worthwhile. And so knowing that I had a mind that skips from track to track to track, I was saying, how am I going to remember these three chords? But it was grace that allowed me to come back to the United States, and I bought a little Korg, and I found those three chords. And next month I found Stephen Kalinich at a party, he had written some lyric, and I was eager to get back into starting to write songs. I hadn't been writing songs. I was eager to see if I had anything worthwhile. But it was always fun writing a song. And so the first song we wrote was Soul of a Woman. Made a few demos of it. A rock version with an electric guitar, which I put together. A nice guitar part. Took me a year and a half to put it together, to learn it, to write it. Lyric's a very pro-positive woman. You wouldn't think it's controversial, because it's such a positive song about women. It basically states that a woman's inherent nature is to raise the heart and mind and soul of a man. As we keep getting into this darker and darker, darker period, that song has no play anymore. It's just a very pro-positive song about women. People today go, a positive song about women, huh? Yeah, women, you know, the people that seem to have insight into the nature of our being. Yeah, I can think north, south, east, and west at the same time. Not interested in winning an argument, they're just interested in causing frustration. The difference between logic and illogic. They dance on that pin, that head. Those people, you know those people. So that was the first song we wrote.
When the whole world comes at you, when it tears you apart, just the way she looks at you, eases your aching heart. And the sweet, sweet feeling, she may always be there. What earthly treasure can compare? make all the craziness fit. Strip you bare till you're better. Mending you bit by bit. And she only wants time with me, but she seldom receives. Still the soul of the woman. She's ready, she'll take you inside. She talks and you listen through the many long nights. Sometimes she's calm and she's peaceful. Sometimes lightning strikes. Means to an end. Trying to figure her out, yeah. But she'll surprise you again and again and again and again. She'll make you feel like you belong when all you got is a song. The soul of the woman makes you both gentle and strong.